For decades, people living near this Main Street Railroad crossing in Biloxi, Mississippi, have been saying it was only a matter of time before disaster struck.
We've always said that one day somebody's not going to have enough time to get off the tracks, and that's exactly what happened.
Since 1976, there have been 16 crashes and 2 deaths in this very same spot.
And like the sign shows, the Main Street intersection is a low ground clearance crossing, meaning the road and the tracks are uneven, making it easier for longer vehicles like buses to get hung up. KXAN investigator Robert Maxwell has been looking into intersections like this right here in Central Texas and how to make them safer.
If you don't drive a bus, getting stuck in a railway crossing probably won't cross your mind. But in Biloxi, the low ground crossing, also known as a hump crossing, is being considered a key part of Tuesday's collision.
There is a hump crossover, and then it drops down. That creates the hump. We're very interested in measuring that hump, documenting it, surveying it, understand the geometry of that hump.
Texas, of course, isn't immune to this kind of railway crash. Last August 6th in San Marcos, we told you a freight train clipped the rear of a tractor trailer that was hung up on the tracks. And December 18th, 2011, in Hutto, an Amtrak train collided with a tractor trailer that couldn't cross completely. The Federal Railway Administration keeps a list of all crossings with low ground clearance and posted signage that in Texas looks like this. In Central Texas, the data, though, is thin, since it's up to state and county road agencies to report. We did come up with a list of Central Texas counties with the most fatalities at all crossings in the last 10 years. Williamson had the most at 4, followed by 3 in Travis County and Hayes with 2.
We all have this issue of risk versus consequences.
So is there a physical fix? The director of UT's Center for Transportation Research tells me, due to limited space and money, road builders can't always engineer their way to a safer railway crossing. That leaves a driver's judgment.
In a lot of places, including Texas, there is a move to try to avoid these kinds of at-grade railroad crossings in the first place. And that is an engineering solution. But to try to do it everywhere, it's an issue of cost.
In Austin, Robert Maxwell, KXAN, investigates.
Ultimately, it becomes a question of who maintains the roadway section of a steep or unlevel crossing. Typically, that falls to the city or the county where the crossing is located. We checked with Williamson County, where there are 258 railway crossings. We're told the County Road and Bridge Department has a crew continuously checking all traffic control signs and equipment. As part of that effort, they also check the condition of the road approaching the crossings. The National Transportation Safety Board is in Biloxi tonight trying to piece together what went wrong. The NTSB says it will take up to a week to gather evidence and talk to all of the victims.